Prime Minister Narendra Modi today visited Chandrasekhar Azad Park in Allahabad to pay tribute to freedom fighter Chandrasekhar Azad. The park was renamed after Chandrasekhar Azad, who sacrificed his life here during the Indian independence struggle in 1931. Earlier, PM visited the historic Allahabad High Court. The institution is celebrating 150 years of its establishment. In the worst mass shooting in US history, 50 people died and another 53 were injured on Sunday when a heavily armed gunman opened fire and seized hostages at a gay nightclub in Orlando, Florida. Islamic State has claimed responsibility for the attack. The shooter was identified by authorities as Omar Mateen, a Florida resident and US-born son of Afghan immigrants. Condemning the attack, US President Barack Obama has said the horrific mass shooting at a nightclub in Orlando, Florida was an act of terror and an act of hate. President Pranab Mukherjee and Prime Minister Narendra Modi joined the world leaders in condemning the Orlando shooting. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address the concluding session of the two-day BJP's National Executive Meeting in Allahabad today. In an economic resolution passed at its National Executive Meeting in Allahabad, BJP said India, under the exceptional leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has emerged as the fastest growing economy. BJP President Amit Shah launched a scathing attack on Congress and says the party is getting increasingly weakened because of its repeated obstructions in the path of development. While addressing the BJP conclave in Allahabad, Shah said that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has given decisive leadership to the NDA government in the last 2 years. President Pranab Mukherjee, who is on a two-day visit to Ghana in the first leg of his three-nation tour, said terrorism is a scourge which knows no boundaries and must be eradicated through collective efforts of the civilized world. In his address at the banquet hosted by Ghanaian President John Dramani Mahama, the president expressed solidarity with Ghana, which is confronting this challenge. Political parties have initiated action against their MLAs following cross-voting in recent Rajya Sabha elections. Janata Dal Secular has suspended 8 of its MLAs from the party. The rebel MLAs had voted for the Congress candidate in Rajya Sabha polls, while BJP has issued show cause notice to its MLA Vijay Bahadur Yadav for supporting Samajwadi Party in Uttar Pradesh. The censor board has cleared the controversial Bollywood film Urta Punjab with 13 cuts under the A category. The makers of the movie Phantom Films had approached the Bombay High Court against an order of the revising committee of CBFC. The court had concluded hearing arguments on the petition and is expected to pass an order in the case today. At least 3 policemen were injured in a terrorist attack in Kazigund area of South Kashmir's Kulgam district on Sunday. According to police, militants opened fire on a police party at Nava Chaugam village in Kazigund area, 75 kilometers from Srinagar. Security forces have cordoned off the area and launched an operation to track down the assailants. Bangladesh's Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has vowed to bring an end to wave of targeted killing of minorities and secular citizens in the country. More than 5,300 criminal suspects, including 85 militants, have been arrested in Bangladesh as part of an intensified crackdown on Islamists to halt a wave of brutal attacks on minorities and secular writers. In Lebanon, a powerful bomb exploded in Beirut on Sunday, destroying several cars and severely damaging one of Lebanon's biggest banks, but causing no casualties. The Lebanese banking sector has been at the center of an escalating crisis since the United States passed a law targeting the finances of Hezbollah. There were no immediate claims of responsibility. India will aim to continue their impressive performance in the Hockey Champions Trophy when they face an under-pressure Belgium side at the Lee Valley Hockey Centre in London today. India are second in the pool stage following a 3-3 draw against defending champions Germany and a 2-1 win over Britain. In the second ODI, India takes on Zimbabwe at Harare today. Indian team recorded a resounding 9-wicket victory over Zimbabwe in the first ODI of the 3-match series on June 11. India has won the toss and has elected to bowl. Shuttler Saina Nehwal received a huge boost ahead of the Rio Olympics as she clinched her second Australian Open Super Series title after defeating China's Shun Yu in a thrilling 3-game final in Sydney. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting congratulated Saina Nehwal for her win. UEFA has threatened to disqualify England and Russia from Euro 2016 if there is any further violence by fans. It has begun disciplinary proceedings against Russia after totally unacceptable scenes at Saturday's England-Russia game. Footage appeared to show Russian fans rushing at England supporters after the Euro 2016 1-1 draw in Marseille.